So here I am firing up SOLIDWORKS. I'm going to start a new part, and I'm going to make the frame the injection molded part of the PPE mask. So I'm creating an ellipse and defining it with a couple of dimensions. This is just going to be a reference for me. It's an approximation of a person's head. Now I start drawing in the frame with a series of arcs. This, by the way, is called a bastard curve, which is something that had us laughing in junior high when we were in Mr. Almack's drafting class. But what it is it's a series of arcs that are joined tendentially together. It creates the illusion of an ellipse, but it can be controlled with a series of dimensions and defined and, I guess, reproduced as well. So there's a dimension there. It's 8.5 inches. That is an arc length dimension. That's the bendy little line there. That will come into play a little later on. I'll show you where that is relevant. I'm defining that curve now with a series of radius dimensions over all dimensions, and then just that tip to the center, and then finally how long is that little bendy S curve, and that's that little shape fully defined. I'm going to use the extrude feature and add some draft angle and then thicken it to 1/4 inch, and that's pretty much it for the shape of the outside of this band. Now I'm coming in and doing that brow portion of the model, repeating that same sort of pattern. It's or that same technique of stringing a bunch of arcs together and dimension it out. I'll put in, there's a chord length there and some other dimensions, and not a particularly sexy way to make a part. It's kind of nicer to use splines, but this is a really easy, manageable, controllable way to make a bit of geometry here. So I'm just rolling it back a little bit so that I can do a step I wish I had done before. Here I'm putting in a sketch and I'm going to lop off the top of that, giving it an angle. And then when I roll it forward, I got a little red message there saying that it didn't like something that I had changed, so I went and just fixed that up. Now I chose the right plane and used it as a cutting surface to cut away half of my model. I'm going to work on just the one half. Eventually, I'm going to mirror this across the other side, and whatever I get on this side done, it'll get for free on the other side. So you'll see me go back and forth between the one half and then the full half, kind of, or the full half, both halves. Here I am now picking up that, you know, that point I said that the 8.5 inch arc length dimension is going to be the center point of the side post. And here I'm just finishing off that by adding a series of dimensions, extruding that as well, added draft angle. And here I am just kind of rounding this thing out with a couple of fillets to add some radiuses on the corner there. Gonna add one more. And then another one here just to soften the edge and to come inside to put one. That helps for the tooling of the injection mold, having that little radius on the inside there. So now I'm going to offset the bottom face, and that will make up the bottom half, and then I'm going to mirror across that, and that's almost exactly one half done. Here I'm going to use the mirror command to get sort of like a preview of how things are taking shape. So now I roll it back to continue to work on just one half of this. Now I'm going to set out to do that little J hook at the back. So doing a centerline sketch and an offsetting it in two directions, adding ends to it just to close it off and make it a shape. Now I'm following up with a series of dimensions just to fully define this little hook on the side. So those of you paying attention will have seen, would have just noticed that I made an error there. I dimensioned that to the origin, which is a bad idea, because if I ever change the arm, that little hook is going to be hanging out in the breeze and it's not going to follow the arm. So I realized that, and I kind of have a plan to change that and to do it a little differently. So I'll get to that. So here I realize the error of my ways, delete those dimensions, and I'm going to offset that original sketch, that little sweepy line. I'm going to click on that, offset it, and then that will give me something that's almost like a center line through there, and I will mate that coincidentally to that line and define it to the end, and there's my sketch fully defined. That will always stay that distance from the end and will follow that arm wherever it goes. So kind of a good habit when it comes to parametric modeling. Polymetric, what's that? Anyway, breaking some more of the edges with some fillets coming in and just rounding everything off. Nothing too fancy here, nothing, you know, out of the ordinary. Kind of almost lazy modeling. And picking up that point, I'm going to add a plane to the front of this, and on that plane I'll draw a little circle. This is going to become the center post, so with a little extrude, add some draft angle, extruding it in two directions, and I'll okay that, throw on one last fillet, and a couple more fillets here, and then roll to the, oh, there you go, I'm going to roll to the end, you see the other side pop in there, and that's pretty much all there is to making a little headband frame for a PPE mask. Pretty easy, huh? Piece of cake. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.